This afternoon, just before lunch, some of my convictions were completely destroyed. When Joshua Dubois went so courageously behind the podium to start speaking, I said, poor courageous man. Poor because he was speaking just after lunch. We had this splendid lunch, thank you, Mr. Ambassador. And after lunch, normally, you snooze. And the speaker can say whatever he wants, unnoticed, while the others are snoozing. But the Reverend Dubois kept us very awake. And for that, I congratulate him. Building bridges is not always an easy task. It's as conflict resolution is not always possible. I'm happy that there is another concept called conflict management. I remember my first meeting, one of my first meetings about the chief rabbi of Haifa, Shaar Yeshuva Cohen. We were just joking together. He said to me, Father Chacour, I know you want us to work together, but how can we agree? I said, why not? He said, you see, the Messiah came 2,000 years ago, and we don't believe that. We say he will come in the future. How can we manage to agree together? I said, Rabbi, you don't need to agree. We don't need to make war for that, whether he came or he will come. Let us work together for the good of everybody in this country, waiting for him to appear. He will tell us whether he's returning or he's coming back. Well, I was going to analyze what I understand with bridge building, but I gave up immediately, and I decided to introduce myself as I understand myself. Sum it all, I am a walking contradiction. When I introduce myself, I'm sure you will never forget me. You will forget my name. But not that guy who introduced himself with all the possible and impossible contradictions. And I hope you will bear with me. I am a Palestinian. I'm a proud Palestinian. I have nothing to be ashamed of being Palestinian. I'm a Palestinian Arab. My mother language is this very easy to learn Arabic language. You laugh. Well, excuse me if I say it. You Americans are not very reputed in being high on languages. Excuse me, Mr. Ambassador. You had a president who hardly could speak English, but that's okay. That's okay. Well, if you come with me to Galilee once, I will introduce you to the kindergarten. You will see that even children speak Arabic there. Palestinian Arab, I'm also a Palestinian Arab Christian. That complicates the picture. Because in your medium, Palestinian Arab that goes together is all Muslim, and the Muslim is a bloodthirsty, inclined to violence, not like Mrs. Rahman. And to be a Christian, my goodness, how come that he pretends that he be Palestinian Arab? Well, it's true, thank God, I was not born Christian. And I thank God for that. The day I discovered I was not born a Christian, I was overjoyed. I don't know what about you here. Were you born Christians, Jewish or Muslims, or you were like me? I was born a baby. And only a babe. And when I look at my left hand, I see Dr. Hillel Levine. I say, this is another baby-born human being. Mrs. Rahman, she is also baby-born. And I'm happy. And when I discovered Christianity at my early age, now as an archbishop, I say that the major value of the teaching of Christ for me is to awaken my conscience to this baby-born human being, whether Christian, Jewish, or Muslim, or believer, or unbeliever. And this is a very big mystery. Why do we believe and they do not believe? Why do we believe differently? There is no answer in that. God created us with the freedom of thinking, of choosing, of option. He is amazing in that. Maybe this is for us to practice a little bit unity within diversity, which is the key to all conflicts in this world. To accept that the other has been born baby with the same dignity, with the same rights, with the same privileges, with the same task towards others. And that's a big, big deal, helping us to build or not to build bridges. I receive so many tourists and pilgrims in Haifa and Nazareth. Many ask me, what do we do with this terrible wall Israel built and destroyed all the West Bank? I say, please don't go and try to destroy the wall. It's too strong for you. Instead, try to build a bridge between one Israeli Jew and one Palestinian Arab on the other side. Try to hide the wall with bridges. We will reach peace, I think.